Hey guys, welcome back. So another episode of the Daily Show. This episode is for Thursday with your hosts, yours truly, JR and Joe. JR and Joe.
You said Thursday, but you didn't say the date.
July 29.
Two more days to the end of July.
Two more and days,
tomorrow,
yeah.
It's the raffle.
Two more days, one more day for
raffle.
Mm-hmm. And we're not going to see each other the last day of July because it's Saturday.
You know why it's called Thursday?
Why?
It was named after Thor.
No, really?
Yeah, it was.
So Thor has his own day?
Yeah.
What about Loki?
Loki doesn't have his own day because he's a bad guy.
He has his own TV show, though.
He does. Wednesday, you know what Wednesday is?
Hold on. Wendy.
No.
Oh, I don't even know why I thought about Wendy.
Wednesday is Woden. You know who's
Woden? Woden? It sounds like Odin.
It is Odin.
That's kind of so much of a stretch.
No, it is
a Woden.
No, because back then his name was, they would call him Woden.
With a W.
With a W.
Oh,
W-O-D-A-N. Woden.
Okay.
So there you go.
We're not going to talk about a little bit of Norse mythology. Yeah, thanks
to
Joe.
Oh, wow.
But we're not going to talk about Norse mythology today, though.
Oh,
I don't have anything. Okay, yeah. Okay. I don't have anything Norse related.
So what do we have on Thursday, July 29th?
Why is the keyboard not working every time I press it? I don't know if you guys are hearing it every time I press the keyboard, but yeah.
You jinxed. Cursed.
I don't know. But here's our first observance of the day. National Chili Dog Day. Now, if you guys remember, at least one of Ian's daily show, he talked about different kinds of hot dogs. It is because this month is actually hot dog. National Hot Dog Month.
Well, yeah.
So, it's kind of pretty obvious.
There's a day where there's a huge hot dog tournament. It's on 4th of July.
Mm-hmm.
The Coney Island, eating contest.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So, hot dog has always been a staple for the summertime.
For the summertime, yeah. Parties. Where do you see hot dogs? I mean, you can see hot dogs
barbecues
in the movie theater now.
The movie theaters.
I mean, I know it's not common because when you say movie, you'll immediately think of popcorn or chips, but guess what, some other movie theaters also offer a dollar hot dog now.
The thing is, on Sunday. I prefer hot dogs over hamburger.
Oh, you know what, I don't have a preference. I can eat both, but both of them are not a good source of nutrients though, so just watch out.
So
eat them as a snack.
Yeah, well, not a snack, they're like a meal itself.
Well, yeah.
A snack is maybe a slider or a pig in a blanket
or
a hot dog.
I think that's a better way. A slider.
Slider.
Yeah, there you go.
Because for a hamburger, when I hold it, I bite into it, right? And you just slip out in the back and I...
Right, right.
Hot dog, I just... you can't go wrong with a hot dog.
It could move too. If you eat it on one side, sometimes, you know, like the hot dog moves backwards.
But you just open your mouth and, you know...
I know. But sometimes, you know, the pressure kind of moves a little bit.
What pressure?
When you take a bite.
All right. But sometimes it can get a little bit messy with hot dogs, especially a chili dog, right? Because you have to have chili.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends on the person who makes chili. If it's really dry, then it probably stays on the hot dog. If it's
right.
A little bit more wet, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
That's the right term for it. More soupy. Then it'll probably slip out. And when you think of, what do you call it? Chili cheese dog, right?
Yeah.
You have the beans, frijoles. Chili, of course.
I mean, don't forget about the onions. Don't forget the
cheddar cheese.
Well, yeah.
They have. Sometimes you have what kind of hot dog you can have. You have like a pork.
Pork, beef. Turkey, beef, chicken. You know.
This is a little bit extra, and I kind of like it. They actually toasted the hot dog bun
mm-hmm.
to give it a little crisp to it, and I kind of like it. Yeah.
Yeah, because the hot dog could be a different texture than the bread. So yeah.
The other thing is like this, is you know how when you compare a hot dog and a hamburger, right?
Yeah.
Hot dog, you eat it so fast. You eat faster than a hamburger, you think about it.
I haven't really thought about it.
Because a hamburger, you have, most people eat hamburger at least two patties. I don't know anyone
eats
one patty.
Oh, I do.
So it takes a while for you to eat the hamburger, but a hot dog, you just like one, two, three, four bites in your con.
Yeah, that could be.
You want more and more and more.
Yeah, that could be. Well,
so
I'm not,
you end up eating more hot dogs than eating one burger.
I'm not so much into having like double patty or something. I'm okay with just one, and then
really?
you got the fillings all over, like with it, you know. Just because, two patties is okay, I guess, if you don't have any lettuce, tomato, whatever.
No, I want the whole
pickles. I don't even like pickles, so.
I want the whole thing.
But sometimes they put pickles in hot dogs.
You know, I never was a fan of pickles, and I was like, you know what, I'm going to try it, and I don't mind it anymore.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I still do. So I had to take it out, and I can't believe, what do you call this? Something not related to hamburger or hot dogs, the Chick-fil-A ones.
What about them?
They got pickles. I wasn't expecting it. I took a bite of a chicken sandwich, and they got pickles.
Dude, anything has pickle.
No, not Filet-O-Fish.
That's true. Yeah. Filet-O-Fish is just cheese.
Yes.
And no, they do have pickle. The tartar sauce.
Okay. Gotcha. Well, I guess. Gotcha. All right, In-N-Out then. In-N-Out don't have any pickles.
They do have pickles.
You can add pickles.
But, you know, the standard regular order thing does have pickles.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, you know, does have pickle?
What?
Milkshakes.
Yeah.
But that's the difference.
those are drinks.
So you guys like chili chile?
You know, a lot of people think, speaking about the best ingredients, a lot of people think that all beef franks, of course, is one of the best ingredients. The pretzel bun, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Pretzel bun, yeah. And even though it looks kind of basic, believe it or not, sometimes it could be like a, how do you say it? You could see chili dog being served at fancy restaurants too.
Oh yeah. And, you know, anything can be served in fancy restaurants. Mm-hmm. It's just how creative the chef is.
Exactly. Right. There you go. So for today, if your diet allows, you know, chili dog, not just your ordinary hot dog sandwich. You got to put some chili in there.
I kind of want Portillo's today.
Oh, okay.
You want some hot dogs, man?
Maybe Friday. That sounds good.
Maybe Friday tomorrow.
My go-to hot dog, don't hate me for this, but
Winter Station, don't tell me it's Winter Station.
No, 7-Eleven. It's 7-Eleven.
You can't go wrong with, you know where you can't go wrong with?
Where?
Costco. $1.50.
Oh, well, yeah. Well, and it comes with drinks already. You can't go wrong. Awesome. All right. Oh, by the way, heads up.
More food.
Yes. All of our observances that we're going to be talking about will be food. Okay. Yeah. So, just, you know, heads up. I hope you guys already had breakfast or lunch or maybe dinner if you're watching it at night. Anyway, second one, National Lasagna Day.
I love lasagna and I hate Mondays. Shout out to you, Zach.
So since lasagna is one of the oldest kinds of pasta, I almost said pasta again, cooks have developed quite a selection of recipes from vegan to seafood and dessert, just like, you know, some of the... how do you say, variations of hot dog sandwich. Lasagna, very common too.
Yes, different iterations.
Different iterations, different styles, different, you know?
Variants.
Yeah. Plugging in the low-key TV show.
Yeah.
Unsurprisingly, many families create unique recipes that are passed down from generation to generation, which is very interesting because, you know, lasagna is one of those dish that you can add your own
twist.
Yeah, add your own twist and then some
refine over the generations.
And then you give it to And then the next generation would be how about I add my own?
Then
you know, from my grandparents.
Then you ask your grandma where she got the recipe from. It's like, the back of a tomato sauce can. It just ruins your thing. It's like, oh, I thought grandma was like this wonderful chef, but she's just got a recipe for someone.
Well, I mean, as long as you add your personal twist to it, you can call it. Yeah, you can call it your own. Yeah. Are you a big fan of lasagna?
Love lasagna. Are you kidding me?
I do too.
It's like, really, is it meat?
I like the layering. The layers, exactly. The layers, right?
It's kind of like what I think it is. It's more like a pasta cake. You think it's like a cake?
That's true. That's true. Yeah,
it's a meat cake.
That's true. Yeah, because it's layered.
Yeah,
it's layered and the way it's presented, you know, I guess not all cakes are sweet, right? Though sometimes it could be a variation too, like a kind of sweet, a little bit sweet lasagna, you know? Because sweet and salty, if you have cheese, it works.
It's kind of like a burger, you think about it. You have two pastas and the meat inside, there's more layers. It's like a triple double stack burger.
You just gave me an idea. So lasagna with burger meat on it. In it,
it's
not
same
on it.
Thing. It is ground beef, dude.
No, but like I don't know. Oh, hot dog instead of burgers. Will it work?
Yeah, of course it will.
I should try that.
Meat and bread.
That's true.
Dude, you know what I do? You know those Vienna sausages?
You put it in lasagna?
No, I put it in between sandwiches.
Oh. See, it works. Okay. All right.
It's just meat and bread. It can go anything, dude. You can't go wrong with meat and bread.
For a sandwich, yeah. For a lasagna. No,
for anything, too.
Yeah, that's true. But for lasagna, another focus of the food or the dish would be the cheese, right?
Yeah.
So melty, aside from
melty cheese.
Exactly. Yo. So most lasagna recipes call for mozzarella, parmesan, or ricotta.
But the thing is, you know what makes it so good is the gooiness and also the crispiness.
Would you like those kind of burnt part though? Because I do.
That's what I said. I love the crispiness. Yeah, it's really good. You like some part? You just want to scrape the pan?
Or whatever container your mom left it. Scrape it out of there.
Stop talking about food.
Unfortunately, Joe, we have another one. But
just put a moratorium. No more food talk.
Before we move on to the third one, what about you guys? Let us know if you like lasagna.
Lasagna.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be quite to celebrate all these three observances because they're all food. I guess you can just like pick one. Yeah, of your choice. And before you decide, we have the third one. To make it more complicated, on which one would you prefer to,
it's to too observe? Fancy. They put sesame seed on the chicken wing.
National Chicken Wing Day. Well, you know, just like other simple dish, like the hot dog and the lasagna, you can put your own style and twist, and you can make it more fancy.
Question. Would you... I mean, this, you look at it, it looks more like Asian style, to be honest. You put sesame seed in it. And the sauce is kind of lighter in color. And it seems like an Asian style.
Definitely not ranch. That's for sure. The sauce or the dip. You know, it doesn't look like ranch.
It is ranch.
No, I don't think so.
It's white.
It looks thick.
No. It doesn't look thick.
I still don't think it's ranch.
It's 100% ranch.
Really?
So what do you prefer? Wings with bones or without?
With bones.
Really?
Yeah. I think we talked about that before.
Yeah, we did. You know what? I like it without bones. I can eat more without choking.
That's true.
Okay.
But I still, for me, I prefer the one with bones. I don't know. I tried boneless and I tried, obviously, chicken wings with bones. But I don't know. There's an appeal for me with the thing in the bones. Like the fact that you have to kind of finish the whole meat part and leave just the bone out.
So what I do is, if I do have the bone chicken, right? I put it in my mouth and pull out, all the meat is gone.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right?
I'm like, I'll talk about it in 1 or 2 seconds.
Oh, okay.
I'm not like, take your time turning around like a rotisserie chicken eating the meat up. No.
You're spinning it around.
It's in the mouth, pull out, all meat gone.
Oh, that's a talent, I guess.
It's like a the meat vacuum. So that's what I like kind of like the boneless one. So I just put it in my mouth and just eat it.
Mm-hmm.
But then I realized it's just an oversized chicken nugget
with bones. If you're eating it with bones, so without bones, then
it's like a chicken nugget.
And I believe we talked about this before already. The most famous version of chicken wing would be the buffalo wings.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and it's pretty much everywhere here in the U.S.
It's like a finger food, really.
Especially sports time.
Super Bowl, you can't. I mean, Super Bowl and
buffalo chicken wings everywhere.
It's like synonymous. Right? Mm-hmm. It's like always together.
Yeah. So, and by the way, it is a very convenient kind of food, like what Joe said, finger food. You can just like get one or two, you know?
No one's gonna get one or two, you crazy.
No, I'm just saying.
We're talking about like tens and twenties here.
That's true. But what I'm saying is like compared to actually sitting down, having a fork and spoon,
I know.
You know, you can just like grab one, go back for another until you fill your stomach.
I don't know any person who just eat one or two buffalo wings and they're done.
No, of course not. But the convenience of eating it with just your hands, pretty awesome, you know? Just make sure you wash your hands before you take it on a plate, just say. So, you want to be fancy? I guess you can use a fork. But not a toothpick. Yeah, it's going to be too small.
No, you know, I know some people who actually use a fork and a knife. They would use a fork to hold the wings and use a knife to slide off the meat.
Mm-hmm.
Then
but what about the meat in between the bones?
That's what I'm saying.
You can't.
If you do that, right? Just get the boneless one. Oh, man.
Yeah.
You know, the one thing I hate the most is people who don't finish all the meat.
Yeah, I feel you.
It's like a waste. It seems like it's such a waste.
Yeah, I feel you. So you know
how we have the chicken wings, right? You eat it, and there's meat in between, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's not for me. The chicken wing is not done until those two bones are
separated.
Separate, exactly.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yeah. I even like go after the white bone.
The cartilage too, right?
Yes.
Exactly.
Oh man.
My guy.
But yeah, that's I gotta make sure I finish the chicken wings all the way to the bones.
So before we wrap this up, right, what condiments and sides do you like with your wings?
For me,
I like ranch and carrot.
Well, let's start with the flavor, because there's plain.
Yeah,
your plain old deep fried chicken wings.
That's boring.
But
nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, and then we got the teriyaki style
Asian style.
There's buffalo. Yeah, we just talked about buffalo.
The BBQ one, mesquite.
Mm-hmm. There's a garlic parmesan.
Ooh, that's good.
Yeah, garlic parmesan.
Italiano. Right?
What else? Cheddar? Wait, no.
No, I don't think it's cheddar. Cheddar is not the same flavor.
Like cheddar cheese barbecue wings? Or barbecue wings? Buffalo wings?
Okay, teriyaki is more soy sauce based, huh?
Yeah.
There's a lot of flavors, I just can't recall right now.
There's
spiciness too.
And the spicy level. Spicy so if level. You guys tell us what your favorite flavor of the chicken wings and then your favorite dips. Now we can talk about the favorite dips. I would say
you can go on ranch.
Ranch, yeah.
What size?
But when it comes to chicken wings though, I'm not much of a dip guy. Like I can eat whatever the flavor is on the chicken wings without dipping it.
You know you're right. So for me it's like this. One wing is a dip, the next one I eat while dip. Next one I eat with dip and without dip.
Oh yeah, there you go.
You're alternating, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you can have buffalo sauce too as a side thing.
Yeah.
So you know when I first said like people who are like eating the chicken wings without any seasoning, right? It's fine because you have different dipping.
That's true.
Yeah, it's pretty dipping. Yeah.
I haven't actually tried dipping a chicken wing in a mustard sauce or like
honey mustard.
Honey mustard. Really
good.
So
I think that's good.
I should try it, I guess.
I like honey mustard. Yeah.
So there you have it, guys. Those are our observances. Again, they might be quite a challenge for you because they're all food. I'm only going to recommend you to celebrate one, you know. If with that said, I'm gonna ask Joe if you get the chance, which of these food will you celebrate?
Hot dogs.
The hot dogs. Okay, the hot dogs.
No, actually, no. Wings.
Wings.
Cause hot dogs has carbs, a lot of carbs.
Okay.
Cause of bread.
So there you go. More protein for you then.
I get that hot dog breath too.
Oh, okay.
You know, I don't know.
Does it bother you?
It does bother me. Okay. I'd be burping up hot dog all day.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right.
I don't know. Something about the beef, how they boil the beef.
Mm-hmm.
Chicken wings.
Chicken wings. Chicken okay. Wings. For me, I think for a change, if I can, I would try lasagna. Because I'm thinking about it. I can't remember when was the last time I ate a piece of lasagna. So yeah. A slice.
I have a little problem with this observance. It says chicken wing.
But you see the leg?
No. It says chicken wing. No. Like I said, you can't eat just one. It has to be chicken wings.
Yeah, that's true.
Uh-huh. Yeah. That is our observance. All food. What a coincidence.
I know.
Right?
I'm not sure if you guys are watching it early in the morning. If you are, then...
Hey, you have something you plan for lunch and dinner.
There you go. Not late at night. So today in history, moving to this portion,
on July 29th,
we have this. In 1958, NASA was created. Well, it's interesting because if you guys watched Ian's episode yesterday, he talked about the same piece of history, but in his case, yesterday was the day when they signed the bill to pass NASA. And I guess
what does NASA stand for?
Oh, National Aeronautics and Space Administration.
Very good.
So, I mean, it's in my script.
I was giving you a freebie. Come on, man. I'm making you look... Well, you have to...
Oh, no.
JR.
Better to be honest.
All right, fine.
Yeah.
Okay, George Washington.
So, NASA...
Okay, but how about this? Speaking of George Washington, who was the president that helped create NASA?
Would you care to tell us?
I think it's JFK.
You think it's JFK?
Because he said he said a famous quote, like, we do something not because it's hard, but I forgot the quote.
Yeah.
But he's the one that wanted to do the moon race.
Mm-hmm. And hey, guess what? I guess we won that race. So there you go. But the thing is, again, US.
We did.
US, Russia, when it comes to space race, we compete, but at the end of the day, whatever we accomplish benefits the whole humanity.
You know why we won the space race? Because we took our time while the other guy was rushing it.
Anyways, NASA has since sponsored space expeditions, both human and mechanical. I think the most recent one is our journey to Mars. We have the rover. And that is a
Curiosity.
Yeah, that is just mechanical. There's no humans involved in there. Yeah, it's not a man mission. Did I say man-made? I mean manned mission. There you go. Mission. And NASA also played an important role by yielding vital information about the solar system and the universe. So, yeah, it's given. We got a lot of these Greek philosophers and early astronomers who's studying the stars in the sky, right? But NASA gave us more substantial
proof.
Exactly. Fact. Like we actually get visual, and we even have physical samples.
We turn theory into a law.
Right. Yeah. So they also launched numerous Earth orbiting satellites that have been instrumental in everything, not just about the solar system, but in our own benefit too. Weather forecast, navigation,
GPS,
and global communication.
Internet too.
Yes, yes.
Calls, there you go. Cell phones, satellite, TV.
So it is pretty awesome.
It is.
I don't think they can protect us from like a huge asteroid yet though. So hopefully we would have that technology if that threat ever comes in the future, you know, like Armageddon or Deep Impact. Those two movies were like the biggest in the 90s. Like,
yeah, it was.
Like, oh no, look at Bruce Willis. You got the Aerosmith soundtrack, you know, but yeah.
Ugh,
NASA.
Awful. Sounds awful, 90s.
It is kind of weird though that 90s. You're going to send people who are, I guess, who specialize in drilling oil, to drill and break the asteroid that was supposed to hit Earth. But again, Hollywood, right?
Hollywood.
So, there you go. Notable figure born today, we have Walter Hunt.
Was he a hunter?
No, he was not a hunter. He is or was a mechanic and independent inventor.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So he was born in Martinsburg, New York.
Ooh.
And I think it's good to emphasize the word independent inventor because...
What did he invent?
Well, the thing is, he secured a place in American history by inventing useful everyday devices. Mm. The most notable ones that he invented were the safety pin and the sewing machine.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So very... I mean, come on, we still have those right now.
I mean, safety pin, but before it was just like a needle, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now it can be bent and the sharp point is concealed itself inside its own... lock.
Yes.
So it's very important.
And again, it's kind of, I guess, quite notable to emphasize independent inventor because he, you know, spent his own money. He didn't get any funding, you know. So there you go. 1796, Walter Hunt.
And safety pin.
Safety pin. Sewing machine too. There you go. Place of the week, we're still talking about Estonia. So we'll talk about a notable place that you guys may visit or may like to visit.
Rakvere.
Over there, yeah, we got the Rakvere castle. So but first, northern Estonia is home to Rakvere, a city where humans have lived for nearly 1500 years.
Wow, that's a long time.
So pretty awesome to think about it. The city's biggest attraction is the picture that you're seeing. It's mirrored. I forgot the video is mirrored. So right there is the Rakvere castle, which was constructed in the 16th century. The castle has become a kind of medieval park theme. So, I mean, come on, it's a castle, so.
What use can you have? You have no more kings and queens, just make it an amusement park.
Yeah. A custom visitor and staff wander the grounds. You can watch knights polishing their armor, see an alchemist workshop, and again, you know, it's a theme park now, so. And tour the ancient wine cellar.
Ooh.
So, and I guess castles are, but, I mean, by default, they're pretty big. So there's a lot of things that you can see inside. Visiting this castle is an unforgettable way to bring history to life.
Mm.
So again, if you guys are happy to be or to go to Estonia,
visit
the Rakvere castle.
Rakvere castle.
Do you guys see it in the picture? They got limited parking though, right there. I only see like a very handful number of cars.
It's like 10 cars.
Yes. All right, now stuff of the day. Let's start with the animal of the day. We have
macaw,
scarlet macaw. Yeah, you guys, do you remember this character from any Disney movie or Disney films, animated film?
Rio. No, that's Pixar.
Yeah, that's Pixar. Well, some, you know, Pixar and Disney, I guess, are kind of like together.
That one guy,
I'll give you a clue. His name is Lago. Yeah, there you go. The Jafar's parrot, or I guess macaw, right there.
Yeah, I did. So what I thought was this macaw, right? They're more tropical. How come they're in the desert?
I know, right?
I know. I just thought about that. Like, Aladdin was in the desert. It's like, the, yeah, Middle East. Why would they have a tropical bird there?
You know what? I have a. There's an explanation for that.
Oh, really?
Because Disney. That's why.
That's okay.
Well, I mean, you know.
Okay.
But if you saw, I'm pretty sure you already saw the animated film Aladdin. Not the live action, but the, you know, animated film, right?
Of course, yes.
Jafar was like the villain.
The sorcerer.
So you would think Lago was also a villain, but he's not really that annoying, you know. Actually, I kind of like his character. So anyways, but Lago's real type of animal or bird is the scarlet macaw. And scarlet macaw is one of the 17 species of macaw. And they're the most beautiful members of the parrot family. And one of the largest neotropical parrots. They prefer life in the rainforest, which is total opposite of Aladdin.
Lago.
Unless they live in oasis, you know. And then they have wide, strong wings and hollow bones that aid flight. They can reach speeds of about 35 miles per hour.
Driving slow, five below the speed limit.
Well, I mean, you gotta consider your size too. They're not really that big of a, you know, they're not a big size bird. So
yeah.
35 but
miles per hour, man.
Again, for me, the best part of scarlet macaw is its color combination. Just look at very amazing color combination.
It kind of look like a heat
vibrant
map.
Huh?
It kind of look like a heat map.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, you got different color of the different parts of the body, like the
head is like really hot, the wings are cool.
That's what you see on the weather forecast.
Yes. Yeah, exactly.
So there you go.
It's beautiful though.
What else can we talk about the macaw? Oh, the beak. They have a strong curved beak to crack hard nuts and seeds. They have a tongue that can hold onto the kernel and pull it from the shell. And lastly, since a macaw is a part of a parrot family, they could also try, or they also have the ability to mimic sounds. Yeah, right. There you go.
They parrot.
Yes. They're omnivores, okay, and their average lifespan is around 50 years. So,
wow,
pretty awesome.
Long time.
Mm-hmm. As long as they're being taken care of properly. Yes. All right, summer plant of the day, we have cherry. So now I personally don't like the, I think I told you guys this already, but cherry flavored drink, cherry flavored pie. Oh, not pie, cherry flavored
tart
ice cream or it's something.
Tart for you, huh?
Yeah. I'm okay with that, but the actual cherry, I'm not a big fan of, so I'm really sorry, but I'm not, you
really?
Know.
Huh.
Yeah. I'm kind of weird for some reason.
You are weird, buddy.
I
love cherry coke. Cherry coke is my favorite. Cherry
yeah, like that one. Like cherry coke. I like cherry coke, but if I'm going to eat an actual, but you do eat actual cherries.
Yeah, the thing is, I want like real cherry coke where they actually put cherry in it.
Oh, interesting.
So I do eat a cherry. But okay. I can't eat it by itself. No, I can't eat it by itself. It has to be paired with something.
Okay. Okay. Cherry is one of those well-known fruit, so instead I'm going to give you guys some fun facts about cherries. The average cherry tree has 7,000 cherries that can make 28 pies.
Wow.
So again, that's only average. You can go more, you can go less. There are two types of cherries, the sweet and tart. The sweet cherries are mostly grown in California, Washington, and Oregon.
Pacific, yeah.
But the tart cherries are mostly grown in Michigan and Wisconsin.
East Coast.
But since you
yes sir,
you're okay with cherries, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which one do you prefer, tart or sweet?
Sweet.
Yeah. Okay,
I think the tart was is just overpowering.
Oh, okay. Yeah. But are the tart ones being used the ones being used in pies because of the tartness, or is it sweet?
I'll do both, really.
Oh, both. Okay.
It really depends on the regions. Like I, like you said, right? Most of the sweet is mostly on the west coast, and most of the tart is mostly on the east coast.
Mm-hmm.
So you go more east coast, you buy cherry pie there, a bit more tart.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Next would be our musical art of the day. Last song from Bee Gees, because next week will be August. We got Words, 1968. It was written by Barry, Robin, and Maurice Gibb. The song reached number one in Germany, Canada, Switzerland, and Netherlands. Wait, no US? Huh. Well, they already had a lot of top ones here. So, Words was the Bee Gees' third UK top 10 hit, reaching number 8 and a UK television special on ITV in December 2011. It was voted fourth in the nation's favorite Bee Gees song. Hmm. And again, Bee Gees, very well-known band. So.
I have so much hair.
Word of the day, we have still seven letter. Oh, so next month, I'm going to have to think about an eight-letter word
for
a month. Ability for today, it's A-B-I-L-I-T-Y. That's seven letters. I have to count it.
What does it do?
It's a noun. It means a possession or possession of the means or skill to do something.
Right.
Yeah. So whatever you can do, that's an ability.
There's
going to be special ability where not a lot of people has, like
telekinesis.
Yeah. Or I was going to say, what do you call that term where if you see one picture, you would remember it, like
photographic memory.
There you go. That's one good ability right there. If you don't know how to use the word, we have Joe Santos.
My ability that I use every day is patience.
I should have asked you that first, because I kind of just, you know, came up with an example right there. Joe has the ability to jump really high. Speaking of which, what's the highest that you've jumped? I mean, not that you always measure it, so
10 feet,
I guess? You see, well, they don't see that car right there. You think you can jump over it?
No, I definitely can.
Oh, okay, pretty good. Yeah, okay. That's jumping really high.
10 feet, I guess.
Wow.
10 feet, yeah.
If you're doing the actual high jump thing, like where you kind of soar your body.
Oh, I can't do that.
Through the air. Well, you just said 10 feet.
Is that 10 feet?
Well, kind of, somewhere there.
No, 10 feet with my hands touching. I can't 10 feet lift.
Oh, so reaching.
Reaching,
okay.
10 feet. I can't dunk. Can you dunk?
How high is a regular basketball?
15 goal? Feet, I think.
Probably not.
I mean, you're taller than me, like 5 feet.
Yeah, but I don't jump that high.
That's true. Your knees can't take it.
Yeah. So. And then our last part of the day, we got tech trivia. The first computer mouse was made of wood.
What?
This is the exact picture of the first mouse. So pretty interesting. And the red thing that you see, that's the button. It's not the light, it's the button.
It looks like a loaf of bread or a toaster.
It does. Just look at the other end.
Oh my gosh. I know what those are.
Yeah, it kind of looked like, it's not even USB. It's not even USB. It's not even like... before USB, they had that purple round socket.
It's a 10-pin connector, yeah.
Yeah. So back in 1964, Doug Engelbart invented the first ever computer mouse. And then again, back then it was made of wood. It's rectangular too. It definitely has some weight on it.
Mm.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
And then as far as the, as far as the term, he called it a mouse because the cord coming out of the back reminded him of the tiny rodent.
It does.
There you go.
Nowadays, my mouse doesn't have any tail because it's wireless.
It's wireless. Yes, it is wireless now. So, but there you go. Oh, last time when you guys were talking about, or when we were talking about the history of computer virus compared to the history of the computer bug.
Bug, yeah.
I mean, the virus, they just named it because of the characteristic of an actual virus in real life.
It needs a host to replicate.
It needs a host. In multiple computer terms, they need to have a computer, and it needs to have an operating system for it to function. So, there you go.
Yeah, so computer, wear your mask.
It's called an antivirus.
That's the mask.
That's the mask right there. And that is the show for today, guys. Hope you like it. Hope you learned something new. And don't forget to leave your thoughts about the comments
below.
Topics we discuss in
your
the comment section
food.
Below. Yes, I apologize for all food based observances.
No, I like it. I like talking about food. What are you talking about?
I think what we can do is, we if we have all food observances, just celebrate one. You don't have to celebrate everything.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
So, but the more the better. Mm. I'm just saying. Anyways, guys, you'll see Joe tomorrow and me. We're just gonna switch seats tomorrow. And
I'm in the hot seat tomorrow.
This is the hot seat?
That's a hot seat.
Right. Okay, hot seat, cool seat, right there. So I'll stick to the cool seat tomorrow. And there you go. Bye for now, guys.